In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today being a Saturday, we offer this Eucharist in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Let us ask for her prayers, intercession, especially for the needs of our country, for the needs of our families. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask God's pardon and mercy for our sins. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in unfailing health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, may we be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, is anyone among you suffering? He should pray. Is anyone in good spirits? He should sing a song of praise. Is anyone among you sick? He should summon the presbyters of the church, and they should pray over him, and anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick person, and the Lord will raise him up. If he has committed any sins, he will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. The fervent prayer of a righteous person is very powerful. Elijah was a man like us, yet he prayed earnestly that it might not rain, and for 3 years and 6 months it did not rain upon the land. Then Elijah prayed again, and the sky gave rain, and the earth produced its fruits. My brothers and sisters, if anyone among you should stray from the truth and someone bring him back, he should know that whoever brings back a sinner from the error of his way will save his soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let my prayer come like incense before you.
Let my prayer come like incense before you.
O Lord, to you I call. Hasten to me. Hearken to my voice when I call upon you. Let my prayer come like incense before you, the lifting up of my hands like the evening sacrifice.
Let my prayer come like incense before you.
O Lord, set a watch before my mouth, a guard at the door of my lips. For toward you, O God, my Lord, my eyes are turned. In you I take refuge. Strip me not of my life.
Let my prayer come like incense before you. Please stand.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
People were bringing children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not prevent them. For the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced the children and blessed them, placing his hands on them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
People were bringing children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. The disciples prevented the people from bringing the children to the Lord. There is no reason mentioned why the disciples did this. It could be that Jesus is tired and the disciples would not want the Lord to be disturbed anymore. Probably the disciples were also in a hurry to rest, to go home. There is no reason, but maybe if we look at it in the context of the culture at that time, nung panahon ng Panginoon, the disciples or the children were looked down like women. At the time, it is culturally acceptable to set aside women and children. They don't have value. Maybe that is the reason. Hindi kayo mahalaga. Tabi kayo. I guess that mentality persists even now. Di ba? Kapag ang bata nagsasalita, tumahimik ka. Usapang matanda ito. Stop, shut up. You have nothing to contribute. But the Lord rebuked them. He got indignant and told the disciples, "Stop doing what you're doing. Let them come to me." And here, Jesus is telling us, in the kingdom of God, everyone is important. Everybody counts. In the kingdom of God, each and every one of us has value. In the eyes of the Lord, everyone is important. You know, our society has become a value-oriented society. You are only valued when you are useful. When you are no longer useful, you are set aside. Diba? Kaya nga yung mga matatanda, yung mga may sakit, na pabigat lang yan. Sa ibang bansa, mayroong ilang bansa, no, kapag merong karamdaman, kapag matatanda na, wala na silang value, ika nga, they are no longer important, they are set aside. Alam nyo, maganda pa rin ang kulturang Pilipino. Yung mga matatanda, kinukupkop ng kani-kanilang mga pamilya. I think that is a mentality that we should develop. That each and every one of us has value. Kaya natutuwa ako, no, dahil may mga ibang establishments that they are hiring people who are over age, senior citizens, no? Tinatanggap pa nilang maging empleyado kasi dapat nating ipakita ang bawat isa mahalaga. Everyone is important. You know, I read that in Japan, there is a restaurant there, no, which is called a restaurant of mistaken orders. Mistaken orders. Why? Because those who are serving as waiters, waitresses, are people with dementia. They hired them, and you never know what you're going to get, no, as your order, because you will say something and they will bring you something else. But they give importance even to people with dementia. And that is what I'm trying to say. Sa kaharian ng Diyos, ang lahat mahalaga. In the kingdom of God, all of us are important. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us continue praying for gentle rain. God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature
that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures so that your people can engage in productive undertakings and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people whom she loves. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and rock of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no requests be made in vain. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise you, your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.